We've been working on this Trophy Lodge almost since the very beginning of 2020, so as we reach the end of the year, I wanted to do one last Trophy Lodge tour, kind of to take a look at our progress, but as we head in here, a couple of things before we go through and take a look at all the trophies. Number one, as always, I am going to link as many of the videos for the hunts of these animals as I can down in the description, but I did go and look at the description of the last Trophy Lodge tour, and we used up almost all of the possible characters, so I won't be able to link a lot more hunts than the last one, but tomorrow's video is going to be the best of 2020 montage, so I'll try to get the good ones for this description because a lot of the other things will just be in that montage. And the other thing is, these videos have gotten very long, so I'm going to try to do it a little more quickly than we usually do. We'll kind of see how that goes. I'm not very good at making Trophy Lodge tours short, but we'll kind of see. So, this is the obvious place to start. Our Great One multi-mount, all three of these animals were taken just trying to get the Great One. We have the albino diamond whitetail in the front, the piebald diamond whitetail here in the back, and of course the Great One, 633.1 trophy rating, and I think it was like over 100 hours and 1600 plus whitetail killed to get all three of these, and it was so much worth it that I'm very much considering for 2021 a second Great One grind to try to get one of the other racks, but we'll kind of see what happens there. Then we have the fallow deer multi-mount, which has the albino. That one actually is a mission animal. The melanistic, which I messed up and I've talked about that before. That one is definitely linked in the description. And a 267.3 diamond. I like that a lot, actually. I want to get a gold melanistic or a gold piebald. That's something to definitely maybe work on Te Awaroa, but it's one of my favorite ways to have the entrance, like the two different multi-mounts with three animals. I've had several different entrances, and I like that one a lot. I want to try to do this by room so I don't forget anything, because a lot of times I've had to go back and edit things in that I missed, but we have diamond teal on either side up here. We have a diamond pronghorn and a diamond mountain goat on opposite sides of, I believe, my smallest or second smallest diamond Rocky Mountain elk in terms of trophy rating. It looks the biggest. It's got a huge frame. I don't know why it scores lower, but I wanted that one there because of the giant frame. Then this is, if you remember when legendary water buffalo basically weren't making diamond very often, this guy made it and he was 202.7, and eventually I do want to replace almost all the water buffalo in this Trophy Lodge because they only get into the 170s now, and a lot of these were like the 190s when mythicals were making diamond very easily and stuff, so those I do want to take down, but for the moment I've still got them hanging up there. One thing we've definitely done is increase our collection of rabbits in the Trophy Lodge, so we'll definitely see those as we go along, but that guy is a 6.6 scoring whitetail jackrabbit. There are going to be a lot of diamond teal, so I'll probably not mention much other than when they're different. So 4.6 is like the usual score for them, and that guy happens to be a red fur type. So any common 4.6s I'll probably kind of just skip over like these top two. But then we have two diamond mouflon. I think they're the only diamond mouflon in the lodge. 183.7 and a 184.4. They're the different fur types, I've talked about this before, both commons, but that one's like a lighter and that one's kind of like a darker fur type. This I just put here, it's a diamond axis deer. The diamond axis were way too common, but I like that better than a piebald harlequin duck that I had there, so I don't know. I kind of like just like the skull plate mount, so I might keep that, but two diamond red deer, 254.6, that was actually my first one with the Truex, and a 252, which looks bigger, but apparently scores lower. And then we just have two diamond springbuck, both of the horn shapes, 111.4 and 112.1. I really like the big horns for them a lot better, but I like having the variety, even if there's no true horns, just the two different horn shapes I like a lot. And I think, other than our diamond European hare here, at 6.6 as well, I didn't realize it was the same as the jackrabbit, that should be this entire room. So then going into this room, we'll just go ahead and start with the centerpiece here. A melanistic mountain lion stalking a 412.8 diamond Roosevelt elk. I believe that was actually shot on stream, and he was max weight, if I'm not mistaken. Let's also do the side animals so I don't forget. A 6.5 diamond jackrabbit, and actually this brown hybrid goose is a silver, so I want to eventually get that taken down, as well as the grizzly bear. Albino female and melanistic female. I'd love to do exactly what we have here, but with like higher scoring males. So eventually, hopefully we can do that. But then on either side, we have diamond red deer. And then inside of those, we also have the diamond reindeer. That one is 447 and this one is 443. This is something I definitely want to improve still. I like the leucistic gold black buck at 25.6, but the melanistic on the other side is still just a silver, so I want to improve that eventually. Maybe while we're trying to get a better looking diamond Mjolnir, we can actually get that off the list. We'll have to see. But this is one of the bigger diamond Rocky Mountain elk I have, and I mean, you can see like the frame size, and then compared with the one out here, which is like 20 points lower, this one looks way bigger, and that's kind of what I was talking about earlier. But anyway, this guy is apparently higher scoring. Then we have two more geese that I actually want to replace, a 6.6 brown hybrid male. 6.8 is gold, so we were close on that one. And then a gray female 5.1. Again, just silvers that I want to eventually get rid of. And then two diamond ducks, a normal teal and mallard, which are a little more rare in this lodge. We don't have a ton of diamond mallards. That guy was 20 trophy rating, so actually not that bad. And then actually, we have once again the two different horn shapes for diamond springbuck, 111.6 and 111.2. We have two different mule deer back here. This one is probably the best looking diamond true rex one I have, and it's not the best. I just mentioned that I want to improve that, so hopefully that can be a 2021 project. And then just the legacy one beside him, which I guess I do want to get rid of, but at the rate we're going getting decent looking true rex ones, it might take a while. We've got a Melanistic 15.6, I believe that is the gold requirement, so just barely made it for that mallard. We have a Leucistic gold plains bison, a couple of diamond wildebeest with the bigger horns, and then just a mountain goat in the middle. I kind of like that. I don't know why, but I think it looks really cool. One of my favorite multi-mounts, speaking of looking pretty cool, a 5.5 gold albino whitetail jackrabbit. That's definitely the only gold rare jackrabbit I've shot. Then we have the diamond coyote back there, 56.8, and the piebald, which also made gold at 49.9. And I believe that piebald was shot during the Great One Grind and just happened to hit his track, so that one was pretty lucky. And beside that is another recent addition, our diamond brown hybrid feral pig from Christmas Eve. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, the last two in this room are a diamond whitetail and a big rack, I think maybe my biggest, diamond blacktail at 189.2, which I think was also a stream kill if I'm not mistaken. I really hope I'm not missing things, but we're gonna move into the hallway here. This was another fairly recent one, a diamond jackal. And opposite him is an albino one, which I think we shot in the vertebrae or something. It should have been a silver, but either way, that's something I would have eventually wanted to replace. We've got a diamond axis deer on either side up there. This one is the dark fur type, which looks a little bit better. There's going to be a lot of diamond axis in this trophy lodge because they were so common, but I basically took out a bunch of the legacy rack ones, so it was kind of just replacing those. But then we'll go down this side. We have a diamond fallow deer, a diamond whitetail, once again, a big rack diamond blacktail. I think he would be the second biggest then at 187.7. And another legacy rack diamond mule deer. Again, if we can get some good looking true racks ones, I definitely want to put one of those here. But for the moment, we just have the legacy rack. We'll go back so we don't miss anything. I guess this would be my best, like, big rack diamond red deer. The first one we shot with, like, the two different antlers actually does score a little bit higher. But we have him here with a melanistic female. And we'll just do the other multi-mount to keep in line here. Again, I do want to actually replace it because it is a silver albino grizzly bear, but I don't know. They're quite rare, and that was pretty cool. And then, of course, the diamond there fighting him. On this wall, it's mostly a bunch of ducks. I think, unless I'm missing one, it should be all the different rares. They're not really that rare for mallard, but melanistic, brown hybrid, leucistic, and piebald, all gold scoring. Then we have a diamond kudu at 32.5 and a diamond blackbuck at 28.7. I just kind of like the sort of spiral horns opposite each other. And I want to say this is the only diamond caribou in the lodge, and they don't make diamond at 400 anymore. It's like 430 now. But I like this rack. It's got like the split backs. I just think it looks really cool, so there's no way I'm getting rid of that. It made diamond at the time, so I want to keep them there. But I would definitely have missed, if I didn't look down, our diamond European rabbit. He's our only diamond one. We do have a couple of rares now, but we just got that guy on, I think it was on a feral pig hunt, on Te Aroha National Park. And beside him is just a little diamond harlequin duck. And I'm pretty sure for the front half of the hallway, that should be it. So one of the best multi-mounts in the lodge. I don't think it quite is on the same level as the Great One multi-mount, but an albino 136 Cape Buffalo. We have, I think that's going to be my biggest diamond lion at 49.6. Blonde female at 38.1. And for the moment, just a common female, 39.8. I want to get another rare female, but obviously that's a little easier said than done. And I think we'll go back this way to make sense of things. two diamond scrub hair, 5.6 and 5.5. Apparently there are different fur types, but I cannot see the difference, so one's brown and one's chestnut, apparently. Above them, we have a diamond Cape buffalo and one of the more recent diamond plains bison. I think that's the one we shot in the same video as our diamond moose, which we'll see in a minute. We have our brown diamond Cape buffalo, which I was hunting for forever. That was actually just a random multiplayer kill, though. We have another diamond jackrabbit and another diamond plains bison, which that one I think was on a wolf hunt or something like that. And then just four diamond ducks. I guess two of them are teal. That would be the minimum score for Harlequin, minimum score for the teal, and almost a minimum score for the mallard. I think 19.6 is the minimum. So I guess we'll go this way since I did just mention the diamond moose. Again, one of the most recent additions, a 275.2 level 4 actually diamond moose. That's just kind of the influence of Trudex. Then this wall, I definitely like what we have going, but I probably want to do something a little bit different eventually. We have two diamond Cape buffalo, a 151.7 and a 152.1. A diamond European bison, that was a recent one. I actually can't even remember exactly how that happened. I think it was just random. I shot it with the 454. And then a albino gold bull moose. We actually have one of each, albino, piebald, and melanistic golds in here, which we'll see the other two in just a moment. I think they're back this way anyway. Now we have another just set of four diamond ducks. This time two of them are Harlequin ducks, 7.2 and 7.4, so that one's actually quite a nice one. And then just two normal diamond cinnamon teal. We've got access deer kind of in the same way we had out there in the front, just some skull plate mounts and more water buffalo that I also want to replace because they were probably mythicals. Even if they weren't, they were just making diamond too common. And then more recent stuff, our diamond chamois, which we just shot the other day, and the melanistic gold female, which, again, melanistic chamois aren't actually rare, at least they weren't at the time that I shot this, so I want to replace it, but for the moment, that's what we have. But then, I think this is the first of the max score animals in this trophy lodge that we've looked at, unless I've overlooked one. 24 scoring diamond black bear. We have yet another diamond legacy rack mule deer. There's actually more in here than I remembered. But we have a diamond bighorn, diamond pronghorn, and actually a kind of unique diamond whitetail. He's not big at 277.9, but he's got like an interesting bend in his main beam. I just like the fact that he's a little bit different, so I haven't actually taken him down yet in favor of something else, but two more diamond bighorn. I think, yeah, this one would be the bigger horns. I definitely like them better, like the mass on the head just looks nicer compared to like kind of the gap between the horns there. But then, I'm not sure, the only diamond legacy red deer that we've seen have just been the skull plate mounts in the second room, but this was the biggest one, 264.9. I want to say that was a stream quattro kill, if I'm not mistaken. I might be wrong about that, but I think that's where we got that. Another fairly recent one, 28.6 diamond cinnamon brown bear. It might be my best one ever. I believe it is. And behind that, just so I don't forget, a diamond light gray Rocky Mountain elk. Actually, that is one smaller than the one out front, so I guess the one out front is the second biggest, but this guy doesn't have like the giant frame. And behind that we have one of the moose that I mentioned, a gold melanistic 216.9. This is not the piebald gold, this one is a 165.6 silver, so another thing to eventually replace. Diamond Cape buffalo and another diamond Roosevelt, 400.5 on that guy. I just have one of the many rare whitetail that we shot on the Great One Grind over here. He was a gold at 220.9, so I may keep him, but I think eventually I want to get something else there. And then Diamond Harlequin Duck, that one's at least decent, a 7.3. This was the most recent Diamond Mallard we got at 20.7, and the most recent Diamond Fallow Deer we got at 264.9 over there on Te Aroha. I think that is it for this room, so we'll go into this little side one. And this one, I think the only thing that I still want to replace is this bald leucistic goose. It's the only male one I've shot. I think there is another one in this trophy lodge, but both of them were just silvers, so I want to get a gold one. I also want to get a gold melanistic goose. We don't have any melanistics in here, but the rest of this room I'm really happy with. We have an 8.6 diamond goose down here, then a max score diamond gemsbuck, so that should be the second animal that's max score, another diamond Cape buffalo, another diamond whitetail. I want to say this is a mission animal diamond wild boar, if I'm not mistaken. And then a pretty good sized, actually, diamond dark gemsbuck. So, two different gemsbuck in here, but different fur types. We've got another diamond pronghorn. I guess that wouldn't be one of the better ones, but it's got like the big cutters that I like. We'll kind of zoom in on that so you can see it a little bit better. This is the gold piebald moose that I mentioned. I think the biggest of the three rares, 222. Diamond feral goat, which was a level 4 and fairly recent. Diamond mountain goat. This is one of my favorite multi-mounts. These two kudu were actually in the same herd, so a diamond 33.3 and a red brown. And then just three rare whitetail, two piebalds and an albino, all gold. And this piebald was pretty close to diamond at 266. That would be like 10 below, 12 below, something like that. So I like this room a lot, but it's a little bit small is the only issue. I knew I would manage to miss something in this Trophy Lodge tour, and I missed these two diamond piebald cinnamon teal. I don't actually have video of either one. I think this 4.7 I shot off the water and didn't know it was piebald. It was like one of the few times I didn't record level 3 cinnamon teal just in case. And then this one, I knew it was a piebald, but it was flying away and I just did not have time to record it. But they were kind of hidden behind the door there and I missed them. But now I think that's everything for this room. So then the other side here, I think we're going to save this room for after the hallway because there's so much stuff in there. But this hallway is all animals shot with the bow, so this is a 484.4 Diamond Rocky Mountain Elk. I'm finding out that I've shot several smaller ones than that one out front, because that would be the new lowest scoring one we've seen. Then we have one of all four of the biggest animals in the game all on this wall here, all shot with a bow. So this was a 173.7, actually max weight Diamond Water Buffalo that we shot while charging us. We have a 284.6 Diamond European Bison, which is bigger than the other Euro Bison we saw. A 157.8 Diamond Bighorns Cape Buffalo. Did a lot of grinding in single player to get that one. And then a Plains Bison, which actually was also shot while charging us. We have another Diamond Rocky Mountain Elk. This one is 494.3, and I believe, if I'm not mistaken, this one was shot with the recurve on stream. That's why it's kind of like back, not on the sidewalls, but still pretty cool. And actually, a kind of weird one, a Diamond European Hare shot with a bow. I just happened to have the bow with me and saw that, so took it with the bow. But then moving into this room, we have a male melanistic harlequin duck. I didn't record this one because I didn't realize it was melanistic. I just shot it far away, and I guess of all the males, I happened to shoot that one and happened to be a male gold, which was pretty cool. We have our only diamond sika deer for the moment, a dark spotted one. I do want to get back to hunting them because I've seen a lot with like less straight main beams, and I don't love the look of this one, but he's a good scoring one, so definitely can't omit him. This is, I think, a mythical diamond water buffalo, but that's not one I want to replace because that is since they fixed them, and they're a lot less common to make diamond now. We've got two diamond feral goats, a brown and a black brown fur type. Two more diamond cinnamon teal, but this one is actually interesting because it's the max score of 4.8. And two albino water buffalo. That one's a silver, and this one here, if I can get it to actually show, is a gold. It's kind of difficult with this multi-mount here, so I guess we'll look at that super quickly and then kind of get past that. But this is definitely the biggest diamond reindeer I have at 458. And then two silver piebalds, which I do want to replace kind of with everything. I want to get gold scoring rares or better. Behind that, we have another diamond reindeer at 447. Two more diamond axis deer, which I'm not going to bother getting too close trying to get the score to show up because most axis deer were making diamond there for a while. And a really high scoring small rack diamond blacktail. And the reason is he's got a really like wide spread. His left main beam there just kind of flares out a little bit, and that adds a bit to his score. But I think that's everything on this side. We have definitely one of my favorite multi-mounts, and I still want to get an albino female for it, but a red brown diamond gray wolf. He was a stream kill, so I'm not sure if I have that one in a video anywhere. I think I do. But then we have a melanistic and egg white female. Like I said, I definitely want to get an albino for where the egg white is, but until then, that's going to stay there. We've got two more diamond wild boar. One of these would be the mission animal. I'd say it's this one. And then I think I shot this on Medved with the 243. Pretty sure that was the case. And then a melanistic cootie, which was fairly recent as well, that made gold at 26.2. And I think, other than a random turkey up here, which I want to get something else there, that's a like a larger plaque that moose and stuff go on, but I was just kind of filling it. We have another one of my favorite multi-mounts, a diamond Eurasian lynx and a piebald female, which We just had that last month, and it's just, I wanted to get this multi-mount done for so long. It was really cool to finally get it. They're difficult to grind, the like tiny animals like that that only drink at night, but we finally got that one done. I think then, other than the back room, it's just these two side rooms we have. I'm watching the time it's taken to record this, by the way, and it's still gonna end up being a really long video, but we have a diamond jackal, diamond black buck. I think two diamond ducks up here would be that one at 19.7 and this one, if I can get it to light up, is 7.2. And then just two rares, 18.3 and 18.1. On this side, two more diamond teal, which we aren't gonna look at too closely. That one's 4.7, so kinda decent. Gold brown hybrid and gold gray geese. Couple of turkeys. We have a 4.5 light brown. Actually, I think he's, if I'm not mistaken, 4.59, where 4.6 is diamond, which was kind of unfortunate, but yeah, you can see the 4.6 diamond just on this side. We have a diamond Cape Buffalo, max score diamond Plains Bison, and then two diamond whitetail. The one on the left definitely is from the day we got the great one. The one on the right is, I guess, about a week before. Then this wall has almost everything as things I want to keep. I do want to maybe get rid of this red female warthog, but the two diamonds are like the different tusk shapes, so 60.5 and 58.3. I think I just want to get like another, ideally smaller tusk actually, diamond warthog for here. It would just kind of balance out. I guess we'll take a look at this multi-mount since it's literally just peeing in our way. This is a melanistic fox, which not only did I accidentally shoot in the vertebrae, I accidentally shot with the 300, so that one was going to get messed up no matter what. I want to get a diamond for that multi-mount instead, or a gold scoring rare, I guess, would be just as good. But that is with a 6.7 whitetail jackrabbit, which I want to say was like max weight and low trophy rating, so he definitely could have been a max score. But then a kind of Cape Buffalo wall, two of the smaller horns, and then a big guy at 157. And then, I guess another recent addition, Piebald Diamond Axis Deer on this side. I believe that one is more legit. Apparently, they were fixed before I shot that, I just didn't really know it. But then the Melanistic, rare Diamond Axis Deer were getting shot like every single day, so that one wasn't special. We have two more Diamond Ducks, a 7.4 Harlequin and 4.6 Cinnamon Teal. Another small Diamond Cape Buffalo. Another Legacy Rack Diamond Mule Deer. I guess we have like four in this lodge, I didn't realize that. But a diamond whitetail, that one also was shot on the same day that we got the great one. Might have been just minutes before, actually, looking at the time that it was shot. But anyway, a diamond mountain goat beside that. That was the light brown that we spent a bunch of time going after. But I think that is it for this room. At least the one across from it is not so just stuffed full. So we have a couple of small animals. Diamond Harlequin Duck. Another Diamond Harlequin Duck, both the minimum score. And then two, I think both silver melanistic European rabbits. So I want to get gold ones. Apparently they're not that rare, so we'll kind of see how that goes. But then I think I've got one of every shape of diamond axis deer antlers. We're not going to look at them too closely, but you can see they're all different. Then we have in the middle a diamond Rocky Mountain elk. I would say 509 is my biggest. Two leucistic silver plains bison, and a diamond Cape Buffalo up top there. And I think that is it for this room. It's kind of nice when it's not just completely packed full. And then, unless I've completely missed something, which I hope I haven't, this is the last room. And of course, there are a lot of multi-mounts to go through, so I think we'll go this way. We have a two rare turkey multi-mount, albino female, leucistic male just because I like the gray fan better than the white fan, and then the diamond, I think is 4.79, so again, we're like 0.01 off of a max score this time. Behind that, it's as close as a multi-mount as I can get to having like a bunch of geese. We have a gold gray, gold brown hybrid, diamond at 8.9. Then we have a light gray leucistic. I think it's the only one I've shot, or maybe like I've had two. It's a male, but a very small male, 4.8, still silver. Bald leucistic, actually, I think that's bigger than the male we have in the other room, 6.3, but still not gold. And then another diamond up here at 8.8. We've got a wolf and mouflon multi-mount. I'd really love to get a gray diamond one, but gray isn't really that rare, so I still haven't decided what I want to do with that. But then a diamond gray wolf a Winter Wolf, which would be the middle one there, also a gold. And the Albino is a mythical that we shot on stream like a long time ago, so I hope that's in the video. I'm not actually sure about that one. Then we have a sort of duck wall going on here. This is a Max Core Harlequin duck at 7.5, then a 7.2 beside him. I want to eventually get a Max Core Mallard here, just because opposite that, we have the couple of Diamond Cinnamon Teal. I guess I never moved the Max Core Diamond Cinnamon Teal into here. I meant to do that. Eventually I'll do that. But then, I would say this is my biggest Diamond Pronghorn at 101. We have, I think, the biggest Diamond Whitetail in here, 289.3. And then an Albino Turkey up here, just to have all the variants. Behind that, we have actually another pretty recent addition, a dark brown mythical lion, just with a common female for the moment. And actually, the only other dark brown I shot on the old scoring system was also mythical, so go figure we kinda got to replace that. We have a Grand Slam diamond multi-mount for the Ibex, we'll just kinda go through quick. Bathides, 196, Gratos, 102, Southeastern Spanish Ibex, 91, and the Ronda is a 110. We've got, actually, another one of my favorite multi-mounts. Seems like all of them are. It's probably just true, but we have a Gold Albino Bison. That was a stream kill. Then a Max Score male Grey Wolf in here. And then just a red-brown female, because what I want to do when I get that albino female eventually in the other multi-mount is put an egg white here. We have the red-brown diamond, and then if we can have that all done, we'll have one of every possible fur type for the Grey Wolves in the Lodge, so that's my long-term goal. This is another actual pretty recent one. There's more recent stuff in here than I realized, but a 39.7 diamond mountain lion, almost 39.8 if I remember correctly, and then he's with one of the oldest, a albino gold blacktail. And then two of the other best whitetail fighting, 288 and 283. We'll do the Cape Buffalo wall super quick, kind of the same as what we've done in the other spots. Two smaller horns and then bigger horns in the middle. And I think the last two multi-mounts, a gray diamond puma, another stream kill, taking down a 178 diamond blacktail, and a roedeer multi-mount. At least one of these was a stream kill, the piebald. But we have the diamond in the back, the only diamond roedeer in this trophy lodge, the melanistic out front here, and the piebald. We got very lucky. I don't have a silver scoring rare roedeer anywhere or below. Since the new scoring system, the only two rares I killed were these two golds, and then we had the diamond in the back, but I hope we got everything. We didn't, because there is a red-brown diamond war dog here. I guess I could move that into the other room, but I don't know. It's kind of like a fur-type thing going on with the red-brown. I like to have it fully displayed. And a diamond jackal? I don't think we looked at that either. 29.6. Now I think we've gotten everything. There are so many animals in this trophy lodge. I wanted to keep this under a half hour. I'm not sure if I have, but we'll keep the outro pretty quick. Going into 2021, I'm looking forward to kind of completing this lodge, and again, I'll say it, eventually, I'm going to do a stream where we take everything down and kind of like redo it, because I feel like we can make it a little more, I don't know, make it flow a little nicer, but we got to get some of these like water buffalo and stuff replaced before we do that. But anyway, I think this video is about long enough, so thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you next time.